No, this doesn't count in a court of law. But do you think Trump had any idea that he was breaking the law when he was asking Mike Pence not to certify? And how are you going to prove that Trump knew there wasn't any election fraud? And how are you going to prove that these were corrupt intentions if Trump thought he was doing the righteous thing? You can't. It was just politics. It's all politics.
Okay, those are great, great dumb questions. Thank you. The answer to all of them is read the indictment, you dumb donkey. It's in there. All of it. Again, it's not just his thoughts that matter. That's not illegal. It's not just things you say. It's not what is illegal in this case. It's not what's being charged. Jesse Watters, try to keep up. But in terms of whether he knows that it's illegal, he was advised by many people that these sorts of things are not possible under the Constitution. He knows that. He was told that. In terms of the election fraud, he was assured by an incredibly long list of officials inside of his own administration that there was not election fraud, that they had not found it, that he had not secretly won the election. He was told over and over and over again by some of the highest ranking Republicans in government, and he continued to say it anyway because it was convenient to him. So I hope that that answers some of your questions. Let's see what else he's got.
Don't you think for a second he's not going to unleash hell on all of his political enemies? This is only the beginning of politicians putting other politicians and their families in prison. Sad we had to go down this road, but this is where we are, and now we have to finish it.
Okay. Ooh. I love when someone says that it's sad and they clearly have never been less sad than they are at that moment. Also being super transparent, Francesca, he's saying Trump is going to, out of a sense of vengeance, just lock up politicians and their families. It'll have nothing to do with anything, but good. We have to finish it. He's talking about some sort of solution that is final. That's amazing. He's the new Tucker Carlson, and he seems to understand the expectations of that job in pushing for mass lockups of his political opponents.
I was just gonna say that. I was like, oh, okay, incitement of violence from your viewers, Jesse Watters stepping into the big fashy boots of Tucker Carlson, goose stepping under his desk there. Yeah, like, and by the way, Jesse Watters will be absolutely fine if any violence breaks out. He'll be there watching from the glass office in New York, being like, oh, get me a cappuccino. So I just don't ask the questions. That's what I think about, like, all Fox News, like all right wing mouthpieces. Don't even ask the questions because you're already. It sounds too much like a lie already. I think he's trying that and it's not really working because he's not a politician. He's the effing president. There's so much documentation about every single meeting he took, when he took it, who he took it with, all the phone calls that were made. There are recordings, right? There are attorneys generals who were attorneys generals is generals who were asked to watch random YouTube videos by Sidney Powell to look into Italy Gate, the most bonkers election fraud theory possible. And they did. They did it all. They looked up. They looked everywhere for the slightest hint of any irregularities and any election fraud that would have handed the election to Donald Trump. Yeah. And they couldn't find it. He mobilized the weight of the entire US government against Joe Biden and against this election and came up with nothing.
Nothing. Yeah. 100%.
The evidence is right there. This is not a politician. It's not a politician. He's the president.
Francesca, the evidence is there, but clearly he didn't do the reading, which is hardly, I'm sure, the first time in his life. But look, the interesting thing, of course, is not that Jesse Watters didn't read the indictment before doing that, but he is surer than you have ever been sure of anything that his audience has not read it either and will never read it. Like, that is the only way that you can do a monologue like that is knowing that your audience is as willfully ignorant as you yourself are. But speaking of willfully ignorant, here's Greg Gutfeld.
The actual charges you can't take seriously. They're feelings masquerading as facts. They're opinions trying to be passed off as crimes. It's garbage dressed up with a legal thesaurus. And it's criminalizing thoughts and it's criminalizing speech. You have every right to think an election might be rigged or fixed. I mean, is every institution perfect?
Yeah, you do have that right. And you know that I know why I know that is because in the indictment it says that you have that right to think it, to say it even. That's not what the problem is, which Greg Gutfeld would know if he had read the indictment. But like Jesse Watters, he of course did not. And so since they are never going to actually engage with any of the evidence, they cannot, because then they will utterly fall apart. They instead have to retreat to fictional territory that they think they can win the battle on. So once again, as I said, nothing that he just said is being criminalized, but they like the idea of being able to say this is just legal cancel culture or something. So they just say it's that. They're going after him for what he thought or what he said or for starting the insurrection. Now, they're of course not charging him for any of those things. But again, he knows his audience won't know that because they didn't read the indictment either.
Right. No, but again, with projection, Greg Gutfeld is saying, feelings are not fact. You know, anyone can think, and then in the same breath, anyone can think that the election was stolen. And unjustly given to Biden. Like, hang on, time out. You just said that feelings are not fact. And then you're saying that anyone can think that an election was stolen. And effectively, you guys have been telling your audience that this election was stolen in no uncertain terms. You've been sued for exactly that. And you're basically telling your audience that this fiction, that the election was stolen, has become fact. You've been riding on the idea that feelings are fact for so many years now. I mean, before Trump, but goddamn, like during Trump years, absolutely Fox News has been the purveyors of feelings are facts. So don't turn it around and be like, feelings aren't facts. Man, that's the whole thing. You go and ask MAGA people, like, how do you feel about, you know, Trump being indicted on all these crimes? Like, well, I feel in his heart he's not a criminal. And you're like, okay, cool. Well, that's normal. Sorry, I didn't mean to do the Southern accent, but everyone, including Southerners, are MAGA or not Southerners, but you know what I'm saying? It's just like, it's like feet, like that's what they ride on.
Yes.
Except 100%. this is not a civilian, this is not a MAGA follower, this is the president of the United States, and like I said, who use the entire weight of the government to try and pursue these faulty claims, and those things, those are crimes.
Yeah. 100%. And by the way, I'm going to close this section by answering another one of Jesse Watters' stupid questions. How are you going to prove that what they said they didn't really believe? Do you not know? Didn't your company just lose like $700 million lawsuit over exactly that? They proved it quite well, actually, in that case. So there is precedent for the ability to do that.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.